Today we are going to show you another part of our authentic Native American costumes for your child. Today we're going to do the boys' costumes, a loincloth. It's going to look something like this. Pretty inexpensive materials, as you can see, but can I just tell you how much your little boy is going to love this? There's two examples and what they're going to look like. Things you're going to need to make your loincloths are some craft paper, or as one of these, I just used a grocery bag from the grocery store. You'll need some nagahide cut in a thin strip. Of course, you need to make it pretty long, so it'll go all the way around. You have some tying room. You're going to need some crayons, a stapler, some scissors, some brown tempera paint washed down with some water, and a large paintbrush, fairly large paintbrush. After you cut your nagahide in a long thin strip, of course it doesn't have to be real accurate. Again, you can talk about how the Native Americans used animal skin to do these kinds of things. Take your craft paper, of course again, this would be animal skin if we were actually making it in Native American days. We're going to take our paper and fold it over our strip of nagahide. Couple of folds. As soon as it feels fairly secure, we're going to take our stapler. We're going to staple so the side that goes next to your child has the smooth side. We don't want the bumpy side because it might catch onto their clothes and catch onto their fingers. So give them a few staples. Again, we're going to use our Indian symbols to tell a story. We're going to use crayons. Now, the one thing that you need to talk to your child about is bearing down really hard with their crayons. The reason why is we're going to paint this later, and the crayon, the wax from the crayon, is going to show through the paint, so we want it to be really dark. Now, after all that's completed, depending on how old your child is, if you don't feel comfortable with them using scissors, you can do this, or of course they can use it, their own scissors. We're going to just snip in the paper about an inch and a half, 2 inches, just to make some fringe, and kind of push them up so it looks kind of fringy. Now, one of the things I like to do, now the kids are going to say, what in the world are you doing? You ruined my beautiful picture. Crunch it up, spread it back out, and then after we do our brown wash over it, it's going to look just like leather animal skin. So after you've done all that, you're going to get your brown paint. You got to water it down. This probably could be a little more watery. Again, you're going to need something over the table, a plastic tablecloth, whatever works for you, so that it's not going to get all over the house. And the kids love doing this. And you just let them paint across their picture. And I tell them to spread it out. You don't want it too dark. And after this dries, it looks just like deer skin or buffalo skin. And when you're finished, you're going to have something that looks like this for your young Native American to tie around and wear to the first Thanksgiving at your house.